Ta-ta.
Yes, teacher.
Can you everybody see? Yeah.
Teacher.
All of you listen, you have to mute yourself so that you can able to listen to the children. Okay. Okay, children. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. We should allow everyone to say, and we should respect each other. We should allow everyone to say. And now first you will listen to the teacher. Let us revise what we have started. Now, let us see. There are five main parts of the plant. What are they? We start with leaf, fruit, flower, stem, and root. Plants have five main parts.
I cannot see anything.
Children, it may be some problem with your network, my dear. Otherwise, it is already there. Now, can you able to see?
I cannot see anything.
Wait, children. Wait. Let me fix the problem. See.
Teacher, what you mean?
No need of reader. Wait, no read of the read. No
need
of.
I may not see anything.
Still you have a problem?
Teacher, I cannot see anything.
Yes.
I cannot see anything.
Now it will come. One, two, three. Children, now listen. Everything is on your screen. There are five main parts of the plant. They are leaf, fruit, flower, stem, and root. Let us see. What is root? The part of the plant that grows below the ground is called root. The part of the plant that grows below the ground is called root. Let us see the function of the root. Roots fix the plant firmly to the soil. It means the roots hold the plant very tightly and it fix the soil so that the plant will not fall off. Please unmute. Please mute yourself. Do not unmute now. When your name is called, then only you have to answer me. Jonathan Hamdi, please mute yourself. See, there will be some network problem also. You have to wait. Okay. Mariam Adel, please mute yourself, please. Good. Very good. Good girl. Fine. So let us see the functions of the root. What does the root help? It fixes the plant firmly to the soil. That means it will hold the soil very tightly, very firmly. And then the next, what it will do, it will absorb all the water and minerals from the soil. And some of the plants, their roots, they store the extra food produced by the leaf. So all the water which was collected by the root, stem will take water from the root. Let us see. We'll come back here.
Teacher.
Look here. Yes.
The leaves make the fruits.
Yeah, very good. Wait, my child. Wait. I will ask you later, okay? Let us revise what we have done. I will ask you again. Very good. You remember? Very good. Good girl. Very good. Okay. Let us learn.
connection to the leaves.
We will start with flower. We'll just revise root, stem, leaves, and then we'll start with flowers. Okay. So what are stems? The part of the plant that grows above.
Which are which image? Which are which image?
No need of the reader, my dear. Look at your screen. Come on, everyone. Look at the screen. Okay, we were at stem. Stem, what are stems? The part of the plant that grows above the soil is called stem. It holds so many things. See, branches, leaves, buds, flowers and fruits. And where does it grow? Above
teacher.
Soil.
Teacher.
Let us see.
Teacher.
Yes, yes my dear.
Is this homework?
I will tell you what to do homework, okay? Not now. Now we are just doing our revision part. What we did last week, that we are doing revision part. Okay, dear?
Okay.
Let us go back to the class. Look at the picture. What are the functions of the stem? The stem keeps the plant in an upright position. What do you mean by upright position? Means it will let plant stand straight. It carries water and minerals from the root. What the stem does, it will carry all the water and roots and minerals from the roots to the other part of the plant. It will give it to the leaves. Then the leaves will prepare food. After preparing food, the stem will take again the food from the leaves and give other parts of the plant. In some plants, extra food is stored in the stem. What are the examples? They are potato, ginger, and sugar cane. Potatoes, gingers, and sugar canes are also the stem of their plants. Understood? Now the next is the last day, last Thursday we did leaves. What are leaves?
What are they?
They are in different shapes, sizes, and also sometimes they differ color. Most of the plants, they have green leaves. What do they do? They prepare their own food with the help of sunlight, water, and air. And then the stem will take all the food and distribute. It will give to other parts of the plant. That's why the leaf is also called food factory of the plant. Why? Because it prepares food for every plant. Not for us, for the plant. Understood, children? Today we are going to learn about the most beautiful thing, most attractive part of the plant. That is flower. Wow. We all love to see flowers. Why? Because of their different colors, beautiful colors, and also with sweet smells. Some of the flowers, they have sweet smells. That's why it attracts to the insects like butterflies and bees. You must have seen whenever you went near to a flower plant, they will be having some bees or butterflies around them. Why? Because we all love to see the beautiful looking flowers, attractive flowers. Wow, we all love to see flowers. Now, look at this picture. I will start from here. The roots, they are below the ground. What are their functions? They fix the plant firmly. They absorb water and minerals from the soil. What about stem? The stem grows above the soil. They hold branches, leaves, buds, flowers and fruits. What are the examples of? And functions of the stem.
Stem. Stem.
The stem keeps the plant upright position in an upright position, and it carries water and minerals from the root.
That will function of stem.
And it will give it to the leaves. Why? To prepare food. With the help of sunlight, air, water, leaves will prepare food. And then again the stem will take and supply food, distribute everywhere to the other parts of the plant. Some of the examples are here. They are potatoes, ginger and sugar cane. Now let us go back to the leaf. The leaves are green in color. Some of the leaves are colorful leaves. We have seen yesterday on Thursday. Not yesterday, on Thursday. We saw there were many different leaves. They were green, but some of them were also with different colors. What do? They prepare food. For whom? Not for us, for the plants. Leaves prepare food for the plants with the help of air, water and sunlight. That's why the leaves, they are called food factory of the plant. Wow! Today we did flowers, the fourth important and beautiful part, attractive part of the plant. Flowers are the most attractive part of a plant. Most flowers, they are really very beautiful. Not only with the colors, also they have sweet scent. They have sweet fragrance. That attracts, because of the good smell, attractive smell. The insects like butterflies and bees, they are always around the flowers. They will sit on the flowers. Okay. Understood, children? Got it? Now, let us see how many children they have understood the class. Let us go to Jocel Hani. Can I talk to Jocel? Jocel Hani.
Yes, teacher.
How are you?
Yes, teacher.
How are you? Say, no. I am fine. Say, I am fine. Thank you.
I am fine. Thank you.
Okay, good. Now, Jocel, have you seen flowers?
Yes, teacher.
Which color did you like? Flower did you like?
Pink.
Pink. Can you name them?
Butterfly.
No, I'm talking about the flowers. Which color flowers do you like and can you name them? Some flowers like rose, jasmine, sunflowers, they are really very beautiful with very good fragrance. Some flowers if you like pink color, you can able to see pink color rose. Okay, you will love to see it. Thank you, Jocel. Can I talk to Juri Yasser? Julie?
Yes, teacher.
Hello, Julie. How are you, Julie?
Good, teacher.
Okay. So, what did we learn about flowers today? Can you say something about flowers?
Yeah.
Okay, tell me something.
What should I tell you?
Have you ever seen flowers? Where can you see flowers? Where you have?
Sunflower.
You have seen sunflower. Wow. What was the color of the sunflower?
Yellow, brown.
Yellow, yes, yellow color flower, and in middle there are brown. Very good. Okay. You have seen very big or small flower? It was small or very big? Some, you know, some sunflowers, they are really very big. Have you seen?
No, I see small flowers.
And you saw a small. Okay, no problem. Thank you so much. Can I talk to Ali Gala? Gala. Ali.
Yes,
hello,
teacher.
Ali. How are you, Ali?
I'm fine.
Okay, thank you. So, okay, which insects can you see? Which insects can you see around the flowers?
Butterfly.
Which insect sits on the flowers?
And
wow,
bees.
Butterfly and bees. Wow, you know the answer. Very good. Bravo. Very good. Thank you.
Bravo.
Karas Imad, can I talk to Karas Imad?
Karas the background.
Karas.
Teacher, me. I am Mariam.
Mariam, wait for your turn, my dear. Can I talk to Karas? Karas Imad.
Yes, I am.
Okay,
I am.
Karas. How are you, Karas?
Good.
Okay. Say, I am fine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Tell me something. Who prepares food for the plants? Who prepares food for the plants?
Me.
You?
Leaves.
Okay. I'm so sorry. I didn't hear you. Leaves prepare food for the plant. Thank you. Thank you so much. Can I talk to Renata?
Teacher, I'm trying to finish. Teacher, I'm trying to finish.
Okay.
Teacher.
Renata.
Yes, teacher.
With the help of three things, leaves prepare food. What are the three things need with the leaves? They prepare food. When they prepare food. What are the three things they need when they prepare food? Air. Say, Rinad. Air, water. Very good, Yusuf. Very good. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow. And everyone, you are going to read page number 135 and 136. 135 and 136.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, teacher.